sense. So now we are going to solve a numerical which is based on Fourier series. So here we have to expand pi x. So here we have two values of f of x. One is pi x between 0 to 1 and the other value is 0, which is between 1 to 2. So when x is between 1 to 2, we have value of function as 0. Now guys, we have to find out Fourier series for this given function. So how to start? So obviously we'll start from the range. So the range is 0 to 2. So if the range is 0 to 2, we have to see that which format it is matching with. So guys, we have done one formula which is for range 0 to 2L. So guys, if I compare this range with my range 0 to 2L, then 2L is equal to 2. So here I'll directly say, here 2L is equal to 2 and therefore the value of L is equal to 1. So guys, it means I have to find out the Fourier series for f of x in the range 0 to 2L. So let's start. So what is the formula for that? So we have already seen the formula in the previous video. So if you have not seen that video, then it's my request to all of you to go back to the video what is the Fourier series and the different formulae to find out the Fourier series. So just go through that video so that you will get to know about the formula. So here I'll write down that formula directly. So what is the formula to find out the Fourier series in the range 0 to 2L? So here I'll say the Fourier series. So I'll use the shortcut f dot s dot, which is Fourier series, for f of x in the range 0 comma 2L. So now that 0 comma 2L is nothing but 0 comma 2 is given by. So guys, formula is like this: f of x equal to a naught plus summation n is from 1 to infinity a n cos of n pi x whole upon L. So guys, n pi x will remain as it is and the value of L is 1, so I'll write down that as 1. So if you write that 1 or if you don't write, doesn't matter. So it's cos of n pi x. Next, plus summation n is from 1 to infinity bn sine of n pi x upon L. L is 1, so I will not write that. And guys, I'll call this as equation number 1. So this is the formula. Now what we have to do is we have to find out the unknowns or the Fourier coefficients, that is a naught, an, and bn. So let's find it out. So the formula to find out a naught is 1 upon 2L. So L is 1, or I'll say 2L is 2, so that becomes 1 by 2. Integration from 0 to 2L, which is 0 to 2, f of x dx. So it's equal to half. Now guys, the range of integration is from 0 to 2 and it is divided into two parts, 0 to 1 and 1 to 2. So I'll divide this range into two parts. So first range is 0 to 1 into f of x dx. Now in 0 to 1, the value of f of x is given as pi x. So here I'll say it is pi x dx. Plus the second range is 1 to 2, in which the value of f of x is 0, so 0 dx. And I'll write down these two terms in the bracket. Now guys, here we'll get second term as 0. So let's focus on the first term. So pi is a constant, I can take it outside, so that'll become pi by 2. And let's find out the integration of x. So integration of x is x square upon 2, that's from 0 to 1. So guys, if I'll put the upper limit is 1, 1 square is 1, it will become 1 by 2. So pi by 2 as it is. And here I'll get 1 by 2 minus lower limit is 0. So when I'll put 0, I'll get answer as 0. So in short, the answer is pi upon 4. So guys, here we got the value of a naught. Now let's find out the value of an and bn. So the formula to find out an is, an is equal to 1 upon L. So guys, 1 upon L is 1 upon 1 because the value of L is 1. Integration is from 0 to 2. or 0 to 2L, which is 0 to 2, f of x into cos of n pi x by L. And guys, let me tell you that L is 1, so it is n pi x. Now, let's find out an. So, now f of x is divided into two parts, that's from 0 to 1 and 1 to 2. And guys, we know that the value of function x is 0 in 1 to 2. So what I'll do is, now onwards, I'll not take a range 1 to 2, because in that range, the value of function is 0. So I will just consider one range, that is 0 to 1. And the value of f of x is pi x. So guys, here I'll say, it's equal to integration 0 to 1, 1 upon 1 is 1, and this will become pi x cos of n pi x into dx. So let's start. So pi, I can take it outside, and let's find out the integration of x into cos of n pi x. Now guys, to find out integration of x into cos of n pi x, we will use the Eilert rule or the Liet rule. So which term we should make as u and which term we should make as v? So guys, you must be remember that in the previous videos, in the previous numericals, I've shown you the shortcut formula to find out u into v, where we consider algebraic function as u and the other function as v. So here I'll call this x as u and this cos term as v. And now let's start. So the formula is u into v dash, I mean u into v1, which is the integration of v. So here I'll say u is x, so I'll write down that x as it is. Integration of cos is sine, so here we'll get sine of n pi x upon n pi. So this n pi is to the denominator, so I'll write it down in the bracket. Next, minus u dash. So derivative of this u, it is x. So derivative of x is 1. Then v2, that is integration of v1. So integration of sine is minus cos of n pi x upon n square pi square. So guys, here we will get n pi. And already we have n pi in the v1. So that n pi into n pi will become n square pi square. Next plus u double dash. So derivative of 1 is 0. So we will not proceed. Here we'll stop. And the limit is from 0 to 1. So guys, let's put the limit. So upper limit is 1. So here we will get pi as it is. When I'll put x as 1, here we will get sine n pi. And guys, sine n pi is 0. So we will get value as 0. Next, minus minus plus x is 1, cos of n pi is negative 1 to the power n upon n square pi square. So guys, this is the value I got from upper limit. Middle sign is negative. Now let's put the lower limit, which is 0. So sine 0, again 0, minus minus plus cos of 0 is 1 upon n square pi square. So guys, from these two terms I can take 1 upon n square pi square outside. So we will get pi as it is and n square pi square outside. And in the bracket, we will get negative 1 to the power n minus plus is minus 1. So guys, therefore, here I'll show you in the different color that value of a n is equal to pi and pi cancel. So 1 upon pi into n square in bracket, negative 1 to the power n minus 1. So guys, here we got the value of an. Now similarly, I'll find out the value of bn. So for bn, again the formula is same. So it will be 1 by 1 integration 0 to f of x, and this term will become sine of n pi x. So let's write down the formula. Now guys, let's start. So as I said, the range 0 to 2 is divided into two parts. Out of that, for the range 0 to 1, the value of f of x is 0. I'm not gonna consider that function. So we'll just consider integration from 0 to 1. So this will become integration from 0 to 1. For this range, the value of f of x is pi x into sine of n pi x. Now, for this or for this function, we will evaluate the integration. So, for integration, I'll take pi outside. So, here we will get x into sine of n pi x. Now guys, to find out integration of this, here two functions are multiplying each other, so we are going to use the Eilert rule, and accordingly we have to consider one function as u and other as v. So as I told you sometime before, I'll consider x as u because it's algebraic, and I'll consider sine as v. Now let's apply that uv rule. So here first term is u, which is x, then v1, that is integration of this v, which is negative cos of n pi x upon n pi, middle side negative, derivative of u, so it's 1, and integration of v1, so negative sign as it is integration of cos, is sine of n pi x upon n pi, and this n pi will become n square pi square, and it is from 0 to 1. So I'm not continuing further because derivative of 1 is gonna be 0. So let's put upper and lower limit. So upper limit is 1. So guys, here how I'm evaluating this. So if I put x as 1, here I'll get 1. This will be negative cos n pi. So negative sign as it is, cos of n pi is minus 1 to the power n upon n pi. Next, minus minus plus. If I put 1 here, sine of n pi is 0. So this is what the value of upper limit. Middle sign negative. Now let's put the lower limit, which is 0. So if I put 0, this first term is 0, and sine of 0 is also 0. So plus 0. Now guys, I got only one term, so I can cancel this pi with pi. And guys, therefore we will got value of bn equal to, this will be minus of minus 1 raised to n, or I can call it as minus 1 raised to n plus 1 upon n. So what I did here is, I have considered this as minus 1 raised to 1. So base is same, so I can add the power. So n plus 1 is here. So guys, this is the value of bn. So we got a naught, a and bn. Now let's put all three values in the Fourier series. So let's go back to equation number 1. So here in this equation number 1, I'm gonna substitute the value of a naught, a n, and bn. So here I'll say, from equation number 1, by substituting the values of a naught, a n, and bn, so this is the value of a naught plus, let's substitute the value of an. So guys, this is the value of an, in which 1 upon pi is a constant, so I can take it outside the summation. So here we will get plus 1 by pi summation n is from 1 to infinity minus 1 to the power n minus 1 whole upon n square into cos of n pi x. Now let's put the value of bn. So guys, the value of bn here is minus 1 raised to n plus 1 upon n. So here I'll say plus summation n is from 1 to infinity minus 1 raised to n plus 1 upon n into sine of n pi x. So guys, here we got the Fourier series for f of x. So this was the question, that find the Fourier series for f of x. Now guys, if you want, you can keep this answer as it is, or if you want, you can expand it by putting different values of n. So if I want to expand, I'll get pi by 4 here. Now 1 by pi will remain as it is. Now let's put different values of n. So let's start with 1. So when n is 1, this will be minus 1 to the power 1. So minus 1 minus 1 will become minus 2 upon 1 square, because n is 1, and here we will get cos of pi x because n is 1. So cos of pi x. Now let's put n as 2 because we are doing the summation. So if n is 2, this will be minus 1 to the power 2, which is positive 1, and positive 1 minus 1 is 0. So guys, we'll get straightforward 0. So for n equal to 2, the value is 0. Now let's put n as 3. So if I put n equal to 3, we'll get minus 1 raised to 3, which is again minus 1 minus 1. So minus 2 upon 3 square cos of 3 pi x. So guys, it means I'm gonna get only the odd terms and even terms will become 0. So this is what the series is. Next, plus. Now let's put again the values of n. So here in bracket we'll get minus 1 raised to 1 plus 1, 2. So minus 1 raised to 2 is positive 1 upon 1 into sine of pi x. Now let's put n as 2. So 2 plus 1, 3, minus 1 cube is minus 1 upon 2 square, 2, we just have n in the denominator, so it's 2 into sine of 2 pi x. Let's put n as 3, so we'll get 3 plus 1, 4, minus 1 raised to 4 is positive 1, and n is 3, so denominator is 3, into sine of 3 pi x minus 1. So guys, this is what the expansion. If I want to rearrange it properly, so pi by 4. From this series, I can take negative 2 outside, which is common. So minus 2 by pi. In the bracket, we will get 1 by 1 square into cos of pi x plus 1 by 3 square into cos of 3 pi x plus so on. And here, this series as it is. So plus, this is sine of pi x minus 1 by 2 sine of 2 pi x plus so on. So guys, this is what the Fourier expansion of the given function. So I'm sure that you understood how I've derived the Fourier series for function f of x equal to pi x. And if you want to learn more videos on engineering mathematics and Fourier series, then guys, do visit Ekeeda.com, because that is the only place where you can get all engineering subjects including engineering mathematics at one place. Thank you very much.